In the previous video, you learned how to use the resize tool to deal with mixing different resolutions in the sequence. In this video, the next timeline effects tool we'll look at is text for 2D title creation. In the sequence, we need to create an animated title towards the end of the piece that says "Get Ready." In the previous video, the timeline effects was applied directly to the segment. In this case, we will create a gap effect above the edit so that we can adjust the length of the title as well as fade it in and out. You can start off by selecting the segment that you want the title to go over. Move the focus point up to the next video track, and if you don't have another video track, simply right-click in the patch panel and create one. Pressing the keyboard shortcut Shift-V will add cuts to each end of the gap to match the selected segment below. Let's right-click on the gap effect and add effect. In the effects ribbon, click on text and the text timeline effects will be applied to the gap effect. Let's go straight into the text editor and start looking at some of the tools. The text timeline effects is divided up into four sections. Starting on the left, you have all the color attributes such as text color, outline, and shadow. The next section deals with the font, its size and kerning, as well as copy and pasting character attributes. The third section is paragraph controls, horizontal alignment, and text path tools. These three sections will always be displayed in the interface. The fourth section is switchable, but the default menu is axis. Axis refers to the object's position within the frame. In the text editor, you can apply transformations to the entire text object or individual characters. Regarding the overall function of the text and creating titles, the text tool uses layers like Photoshop. For example, you can click New Layer, and in the text layer you can type Get Ready. You can have as many text layers as you want, but let's keep this simple for now. There are many modes that you can use in the text timeline effects, but there are two that you will use the most. These are Edit and Move. These are indicated at the bottom left-hand corner of the screen. Pressing Escape will allow you to switch between the modes quickly. So in order for you to edit the text, you must be in Edit mode. To change the properties of the text, you need to select the characters like you would in any other design packages. You can now adjust parameters such as font size, kerning, paragraph alignment, and more. To change the font, click on the font's name box. This will open up Smoke's file browser. Similar to what you have seen in a previous video, you can switch the file view between the titles and proxies in the top left-hand corner of the screen. If your proxies appear to be gray, simply click on the Generate Proxies button and Smoke will create the font previews for you. Smoke supports a variety of different fonts that you can choose through the Format Selection pull-down menu. I'll choose Auto to show all the files in the current folder. When Smoke is installed, it installs some default fonts for you, but you can access your system fonts by clicking on the System Fonts folder. Smoke does not require you to install the font on the Mac OS Fonts folder in order to use it, so you don't have to have thousands of fonts installed just to access them. Select the font that you want to use and press the Load button to return back to the text editor. We'll be covering animation in greater detail in a later video, but for now, let's do a quick basic animation to add a bit of movement to this title. Ensure you have toggled back to Move mode. Turn on Auto Key. You might know this better as Auto Keyframe or turning on Animation mode. Go to the beginning of the segment and position the text at the top of the screen. Go to the last frame and position the text at the bottom of the screen. Turn Auto Key off. When you scrub the time bar, you can see the basic vertical movement that you have created. Press Exit to return back to the sequence. To conclude this video, navigate the positioner to the beginning of the gap effect and make sure that nothing is selected. Click on the Transition button and add a dissolve to the beginning of the gap effect to fade in the title. The same can be done at the end of the gap effect to fade the title out. Depending on your system, you might be able to preview this in real time. To render the result, hold down the Command and select the gap effect and the two dissolves and press Render. Once Smoke has processed, you will be able to play back the final result. In the next video, we'll cover speed changes using Smoke's Time Warp tool.